Hello friends, so this is part 2.4. In this we will complete the shear force and bending moment diagram for cantilever beam. So this is for when a cantilever beam with different types of moments are there. So let's go. So this is first case, case number 9. In this, the cantilever of length L carrying a moment at free end. So simply this is cantilever beam of length L and having a moment small capital M. Okay. So these are the reference for SFD and BMD, and we'll move from free to fixed end and from B to A. Here, as you can see, there is a support reaction is equal to zero because due to this moment, there is no vertical forces. Only pure moment is there. So there is no vertical force. Then we will put or we will take this support reaction is equal to zero. And in this, the shear force, also this moment of resisting moment at the support, that will be equal to M, okay. But the shear force will be equal to zero. So there is no shear force in this case. So the shear SFT diagram will be like this throughout zero. But as far as concerned with the bending moment, then the bending moment will be like this, minus M. Why minus M? Because this will create a hogging. As you can see, this is a section. And like this, this is the moment acting. And this will be like this. So this is hogging, so this is negative. Okay, so we have to select this as a negative bending moment, and here this will be throughout the same. Okay, so at M is equal to B and at M is equal to A. So here the maximum bending moment, or we can say a constant bending moment, will be equal to capital M only. So if only single bending moment at the cantilever beam at the free end, then this is the solution for that. And case 10. In this, a cantilever beam of length L, okay, having a moment at midpoint of the beam at point C. As you can see, there is a moment capital M, and this is a midpoint. So this simply, this is L by 2, L by 2. This is the distance of the beam, and this is a reference for SFD and BMD. Now in this, we will move from free to fixed end again. And in this, as you can see, as there is no vertical forces, and this is a pure moment, so there is no vertical force. So this RA will be equal to zero, and the resisting moment will be equal to M, okay. In this, there is no shear force as there is no vertical load, so the shear force will be equal to zero throughout the length. Okay, so throughout the length, the shear force is equal to zero. But now we will calculate this bending moment, and as you can see, we will moving like section wise section. So first section is from B to C, and section is C to A. So in first section, as you can see, we are moving from B point to C point, and as there is no load between B to C, so simply this Mx, or we can say a bending moment will be equal to zero at any point. Okay, now from section C to A, now this is positive, this bending moment is positive, because as you can see here, now the section is like this. So like this here, as you can see, this is the section, this is the moment, it will create like a sagging. So this will be positive, so we have taken this positive M, okay. And this will be throughout constant, because there is no intermediate any force or moment between A to C. So this will be constant throughout, plus M, and yes, this will be final bending moment for this case. And this, the maximum bending moment is equal to M, like this. Now next, case 11. In this, a cantilever beam having length L and having a uniformly distributed moment, we can say simply this is U, D, M, okay. So continuously moment, continuously points moments are there with the same rate. Okay, so in this, the unit is like this, Newton meter per meter. Okay, so this is a moment M. So next, this is a shear force, and this is bending moment diagram reference, and from section B to A. So simply we will put here, first we will convert this total moment into a point moment. So this is UDM. So this is simply a UDM. We will convert this in point moment, and the value of point moment will be equal to MX. So we just have to take this M into X. So we'll get this MX, and the unit will be like Newton meter. Okay. So for whole length, as far as the whole length, there is no vertical force because all the moments are pure moment. So there is no vertical force, so we can say that this RA is equal to zero. The vertical supports have reaction value zero, and If I'm talking about this resistive moment, then you can see this value is ML. So how it's calculated? So because throughout length, as value is M and throughout length, the length is L. So simply the moment, this will be equal to this ML, okay? Now, in this case, the shear force is equal to zero at X is equal to zero and at X is equal to L, again zero. But I'm talking about bending moment from B to A, free to fixed end. Then in this case, you have to calculate like this, Mx is equal to plus Mx, okay? So this is the rate, it's depend upon the X, the value of X. As the X is equal to zero, then bending moment at point B here, as X is equal to zero, then Mb is equal to zero. And as X is equal to L, then Ma is equal to, at here, as X is equal to L, then Ma is equal to ML, okay? So as you can see, this is a triangle, and this is ML, this is maximum bending moment due to the UDM. Okay, so this is maximum bending moment, and in the case of this, there is zero shear force.